Welcome back to All the Crackers in the Box. I don't know, third video in a row, same outfit, but I decided I was going to do a bunch of videos in one night, and I'm really not feeling like changing my clothes. I'm all crochet-oriented right now, so we're just going to have to bear with my outfits. I am clean, my clothes are clean. I just don't feel like switching outfits in between videos. So, thanks for joining me. I'm actually digging my arm blindly into a scrap box here. I'm looking for a particular color, and I know what's in here because the other one that I did at the same time is right there. Nope, my red one. See, yet another one. Okay, so I got two of these that I'm going to probably only use one, maybe. So I should be close because I did those two balls at the same time. Oh dear. I do really like this one. This one was a pillowcase that I did for my son. Very interesting. I can't even find anything about this yarn. It is a Michaels exclusive. And yeah, I could not find anything. Not even a Ravelry. You think you would be able to, right? Oh my. It looks like I'm getting a beautiful tangle in there. Can't wait to get to that. I love tangles. I know. A little bit weird. I've got a bit of a snaggle here. Pull you through. And keep in mind, I'm also the girl that really enjoys backstitching and cross-stitching. So I'm a little bit of an anomaly where I actually really find this to be very calming. To just unravel. I love the feel of the yarn in my hands anyways. Okay, that is my tiny bit of that cake. You can't even see that. Hold on. Let's adjust. Hello, nurse. Okay. So, that's all that was left from this one, from a project. I don't believe that's a full skein of it, though. Which is okay. What color is it? You are blue, and I see that you're one of the loose colors. And I was just came across. I'm looking forward to getting that yarn winder to cake these up. I also am looking forward to possibly turning this into all these little scrap balls into one great big mixed balls. I've been seeing them on Etsy and they are going for like $65. Pretty expensive. Now it's Canadian, not to mention the other $30 in shipping for one. So I can make those at home. Okay, that is Carnival. Go, and that should be tucked in, and that's another reason why I want to do it. I'm really sick and tired of not having a ball, a yarn ball. Huh? See? Carnival, so pretty. I love my Carnival. That was the first yarns we really got into from Hobie was Carnival. Okay, that orange could be used in my project I want to do next. Where is my pink? There should be a super hot pink. No, but that is a Loopsin. This one I really liked. It's super silky. Really enjoyed working with that one. It's very much like Carrion's Simply Soft, but it wasn't as splitty as I find the Simply Soft. Okay, another ball of Carnival. And that's another one. Yeah, we got a whole bunch of them, and there was a bits, pieces left, and looks like it's from another ball of it. I think I'm going to make something really fun out of what's left, and just maybe turn them into one ball. or just cake them up just so I can see the different color changes, because I really like that. And here's my other one. So that leaves me 4 partial balls. Not bad, not bad. I am considering taking a couple rows out of the shrug my mom made me. It has a lot of carnival in it. I just dropped a ball on the floor. Hopefully the neighbor downstairs didn't hear that. She sure does not like a single sound. I'm sure it's fine. Okay, I have a lot of Lulu stuff. I didn't think I put pink in this one though. Because that's like a mohair. That's my shrug too. And some navy blue and all sorts of fun colors. That's feeling a little doll story. No, that's sort of a weird round. No, those are those teeny tiny ones, and then we have some more teeny tiny. Okay, so I don't think the pink I'm looking for is in there. These are not the drawers I'm looking for. I am looking a bit forward to cooler weather, so these bugs can go back to the place they came from. Everybody knows what I'm hinting at here. So then maybe I can open this up. I did last week, though, have a spider come traipsing across my bed, and I think he came out of one of my projects. The Batmobile's up here for safekeeping. 1 second here. Looks so pretty. I do enjoy their yarn so much. Alright. And I actually have 2 little mittens that I made that didn't turn out very good. I tried, but they weren't very nice. So. She couldn't get her thumb in there. I'll try it again. These are my first attempt at mittens, and I think they're pretty. Like, but they definitely are not exactly the same. Like, this one thumb's a bit different than the other. But they are so cute. I'll see what she says this year. She might like them this year. I am looking for my bright, bright pink. My bright, bright pink. I have this pink. Can you see the difference? Are you gonna focus? Get a focus. There is a difference between them. Can I come up a little maybe? And this one's my hot pink. The hot pink looks really good with this black. So the request was hot pink. Or pink in general. And I could possibly get away with this one. Or I could do a mixture of all 3. With the black, I don't know. And I also have a pale pink. So I got a couple things to choose from here. And that's more peachy. That is definitely something I'm going to rip through this weekend. At least one more loaf cap, but these ones are going to be smaller than my big one. My bigger one was made with your blanket, right? Which is worlds thicker. Alright, on to our next project. Oh, I'm so excited. Okay, so we're starting that up. Gonna get to it. I'm going to pull out this hot mess here. This was good, and then while I was making one of the last few videos, I had this sitting beside me, and this is what I've got going on. So this is all I have left. This is the end. So I'm going to assume that this is the end here, and we're going to just turn it this way and go like this. I think I can take that off. Got my hook. And I should be able to get at least one more in, maybe? 1 second here. Are we going? Yeah, we are. Huh, okay. Ooh, all right, sorry about that. A little confused there. Something was blinking on the screen. Okay, so I think I'd like it a little bit bigger. I do not mind the looseness because I'll probably be wearing another shirt under it. I'm just kind of like that, a t-shirt or something. I think the colors are going to be nice on me. I think my skin tone's going to do really good. I'm probably going to be going back to dark hair, brown hair again soon. I don't have any more red dye, and I'm starting to see my roots. And of course, red fades really bad, so I just did red for fun, and I do it once in a while. As long as it's a really dark red. Like, fire engine red just does not look good on me. Okay, and then we're just gonna get to working. So this is how I roll. I'm doing all these videos in one night, and I've worked on each and every project for a few minutes. And that's kind of how I do things. I do not really like working on just one thing at a time. I enjoy jumping all over the place. I see this project in particular, I actually don't need my glasses. I actually don't even need to really look at it. I can feel where I need to be, and just out of habit, I do like to watch because I actually really enjoy watching the yarn become. Its transformation is very, very exciting for me. Excuse me while I'm excited about getting a loaf cat going. The last one took me about 3 hours to actually stitch up and another 45 minutes to put its face on and so its tail on, just do the finishing touches. Really like that pattern, so I'm probably just going to do the same thing. And she had them in smaller and four weights, and they're really cute, but for tiny, she really wanted a big softy one, so that's what I did. And go like this, and go like that. Oh my goodness. So yeah, I started talking about some books. I'm listening to some sort of like teenage shifter romance that's borderline and very inappropriate because the main character, I think she's underage her boyfriend. That got bit by a werewolf who's suddenly super into her. He just turned 18, but she's not 18, so I don't know. We've had some very risque moments, and that one's on YouTube. I can't think of the name of it. I'm not listening to it tonight. I also started one that I picked up from the Prime Reading Program, but I picked it up like over a year and a half ago, and I just haven't gotten around to it. It's something about lemon cupcake murders. So far, the girl's moving in with her great aunt, who's like 91 and super feisty and just seems like a barrel of laughs, so that's going to be a fun one. And yeah, I'm super excited about it. My son just bought himself a nice laptop, and he actually has been having nothing but problems with it. He wanted one for doing his homework, because he has a really nice big PC, but he feels that when he's doing his homework, it's kind of an overkill to have that thing sucking back the power and being on, because it's dual screen, big gaming rig, and he also would like to not have it on when he's going to sleep, so he'd rather have a little laptop playing when he has, like, YouTube on or whatever. He feels it's going to be less power hungry and a little less invasive, so he has options. Like, he went out and visited his friends today, and he was able to take his laptop, and I guess while they were out eating pizza out in the world, they decided to stop and watch a movie together. Somewhere. I don't know where they did it. Whatever. I guess they met some girls. I don't know. I didn't really hear much about it, so that's cute. Anyway, I will hear all about it later. Love the gossip. I'm so proud of him. He's trying his best to get out there and meet people. But anyways, this laptop has been an ordeal. First things first, the battery that came with it was a lemon. And yes, he did get a refurbished one because he didn't want to spend an arm and a leg because he does have a nice computer. This is mostly just to like watch a video or two and be able to surf the web to do his homework. And he's able to, like, on his break at work, rip through a little bit of math or his English and check up on his emails. And he doesn't like doing it on his phone or tablet. I think the tablet he has upstairs, we're just going to give to the three-year-old for her coloring games and matching, because she's been doing little games that teach you the shapes of letters and actual shapes, and she's like eating those like crazy. She comes up to me and starts telling me all about different shapes and stuff. It's like her obsession right now, and right now she really wants to get into letters. Her dad picked her up a Elmo briefcase that's full of letters, and you pop them in and out, and there's little pictures behind each letter. And she absolutely values it. All the pieces stay in it. She's very particular about how it gets put away. No one else is allowed to touch it. She asks me for permission. May I use this right now? She's like, yes, honey, you sure can. And we play school. So, anything to help the kids get their edumacations, as I call it. So, anyways, he bought the refurbished laptop, and so he had to get another battery, which he got paid for. I didn't even know he was making all these orders, and his original laptop has a 90-day guarantee. If he had waited and let me email his original seller, they would have sent him a brand new battery at no cost. Impatient child doesn't even think of that. He thinks it's too much trouble to email a seller when they've sold you something that isn't working. And I'm like, no, that's not how it works. So I will probably be getting hold of them, letting them know about the few issues he's having. One of the issues he was having was got the new battery, charged it, used it most of the day, and it was advised to let it die completely, so he did, and he charged it, and then the laptop would not turn on at all. The light was on the side saying that the battery was charging, but it was not doing anything. So we had troubleshooted quite a few things. There's a few frustrating moments of mean words, and we got the back off the panel and we unplugged the piece. Now, you have to keep in mind, my husband builds computers for a hobby. I would never, ever, ever advise this for someone else. My son was willing to give up his warranty to see if this fix would work, and that was his choice, his purchase, and he'd be the one out the money because they're not gonna do anything if they know you've been in the back messing around, because who's to say you didn't do it, right? So I had to unplug a piece, plug it back in just to reset it, and then it came on. It actually came on, and then I had to go, and before I'd let him do anything on that, I went and checked the updates, which fixed the date and time, which is what we were resetting. And from what I understand, it's working really well now. And I did look it up on their reviews, and this has happened a few times. And it's just a small, simple, tiny, tiny piece that costs like $10 to replace, and we could replace it ourselves. So if we have to, we have to. But I don't think we're going to have to. I think these are the major bugs that were coming out of it. I would like an extra battery though. So that I'm going to let them know, because it said it was going to have two batteries, and then we opened it up and there is not a battery inside of it that was supposed to be there. And that was part of his, what he wanted. So, yeah. I'm just glad it got working and he'll be able to do his homework with ease. And like, if he wants to come sit downstairs and do his homework, he can, and it's not. He hates taking over my computer. He does not like touching it. And he feels like it's kind of a pain. Or if I'm sitting in the living room, he can't just sit in the living room just for the company's sake. And sometimes I just, having a small conversation with me helps his ideas start to roll. He just needs someone to listen to him for 5 seconds. No big deal. Same with math. He knows it, but he second guesses everything about it, and the laptop has a built-in webcam, so then he's not doing the stuff on his PC, his main PC that he does everything else on. Make movies and that kind of stuff. I don't think he's been doing YouTube for quite a while. He used to, but he deleted his channel. Now I have a channel, but he has a really nice, way better software than I do, because we bought him some really nice software, and he uses that for school projects here and there, but he just ends up taking forever on them, so he just ends up giving up, because he doesn't think he knows what he's doing, and he does know what he's doing, he's just very hard on himself. Anyways, so that was good news, that we were able to get it to work. That is wonderful news. Looking for an order that was lost by FedEx. I don't know where this order is. And if it shows up, I get to keep it, but I got a refund from Temu. That was for a pair of hiking boots we were ordering. My mom ordered a pair, and they came in, but they were a size too big. Or half a size too big. She doesn't want to wear them. My son loves them, so he's keeping them, so he bought her another pair. The second pair is lost. We don't know where it is. And we've waited almost 2 months for it. I gave him a lot of time. I don't like asking for refunds and that kind of thing. So I had to question, hey guys, it's saying that they never even received it at their end. It never made it to the country. I don't know where it is. Like, did it come? Is it here? Is it in a warehouse? Is it in customs? It does not say. And he's made a few other orders since then, and they've all come in, and just that one has not. So, I had to get a refund. Kind of hope it comes in, because they're really cute boots, and they're just nice little hiking boots made out of leather, and good for walking around, and that's what my mom likes to wear for her walking, because of the ankle support. And we're having the worst time finding her a decent pair anymore. They don't seem to be physically around. They have cheap ones, cheap ones that she just is not excited for, and it's not a winter boot. So, it's been a little bit tricky, and I thought these ones were great, and they come out very well, and she is getting a little discouraged. And I feel that too, so we're probably going to have to go on another search. I am probably going to have to go to Michael's, or my mom's going to go to Michael's and grab me a couple skeins of DMC. I'd love to get some more yarn. I think I know how I'm going to get my next bit of yarn. I'll have to look into it. I'll let you know. Think about ordering some other stuff and sneaking some yarn on there. No one has to know. Anyways, I think I'm going to work on this one a little bit longer. I'm super close to being finished with this cake, and then I start on the other side. I have not decided what I want to do for my cuffs and my border. I might just go with a totally different color. Like, I kind of like the idea of that. Let's see here. Because it doesn't really line up with that, but it almost does. But there is also... Oh, sure. Every other time, you're always in my face. But those are all baby soft, baby lips. Where are you? There you are. You're back there now. Gotcha. Okay. Well, this is a Mary Madison. Baby, and I only have the one. It is a Mary Maxim Twinkle. Let's see if we can see. My light just seems to wanna. And it is a pale lavender. It is really, really soft. This one is a super fine one weight, 3.25 millimeter. And I don't know. I'm feeling like. This could go really nice with this, but I'm going to give it some more thought. Because I mean, I do have other options. Lots and lots and lots of other options. And I haven't even gone into my closet or my other bags that I have all over the place. But that purple is my first thought. And quite often my first thought is my last thought. When it comes to color matching and my contrast. But I do have black. Yeah, I'm not really excited about it. And I do have this really fantastic yellow. It's not too much, but I'm not really liking it. Now that I've held it up there, I thought I might. Huh. And I got some colors up there. I've got pinks, I got purples, I got all sorts. I've got these baby ones. I've got more in the closet. And, yeah. You're here on my channel. We do a lot of color comparisons because I really, really enjoy. I enjoy colors. I enjoy mixing them. I enjoy finding complementary. I like opposites. I love. Just seeing different colors come together to make something really neat, especially unexpected mixes that no one else is doing. Anyways, I'm excited. This has been a wonderful evening with a lot of crochet, a lot of things I've gotten forward, touched base. I will be looking at the shawl here very, very soon. This twister here, my only twister. I have a couple options, so I'm going to take a look at the shawls as soon as I'm done with making this one for myself. I'm allowing myself to make one thing for myself at a time. Everything else is going to be for other people. And I think next up is going to be after I'm done my wreath and my bag here. So. I thought something was in that ball of yarn, but no, it's just a dirty mark from the sticker on the outside. Anyways, I thought it was a bug. Let's be real here. And it wasn't. I'm like half panicking. Anyways, I'm going to be doing a start on my Halloween wreath. It's not going to be done this year. I've given that up. This bag has really taken a lot more out of me than it should have. It should have been something done within 2 weeks. And because everything has just been blowing up and not working, it has really drawn out. So I'm going to continue working on it. It should be done in the next few days. Now that I've got my ghost figured out and my border with my dark blue. And I'm just going to do both at the same time. And we're going to get to 32. So 31 more squares to go. Super exciting. Anyways, I'm going to be making the stripe thing for... my wreath, and at worst, I mean, I could just hang it up in here in my room all year round. I probably will end up doing that for a while. I could use a wreath over there. pretty. Anyways, I already tried to say goodbye, and I get super sidetracked because I am starting to feel a little bit better. Anyways, thanks for joining me here at All the Crackers in the Box, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. I hope to see you again very, very soon. Bye.